Well, good morning everybody, it's Alex from Popsmoke here and I'm finally back in the garage after about 3 weeks of not being in here, holidays and so on and things like that. But we're finally tackling this boot. So, here we go. I'll run you through in a bit more detail in what we're doing today. Okay, well this morning you can see the holes that we're going to be tackling first. So, this hole here, this one here, and this one over here. We're ignoring that one for now. We're going to, because we have to cut through more rust there, so we're going to leave it there. You can see I've already made the panel for that one, with the screws and everything, made it for that one, and that one. Already started to clean it up. A bit bobbly there, but nothing bad. We haven't cleared this one up yet properly, because I'm just waiting to get this one all set in, and you can see how this one's all done. It's got its bumps and so on in it, and it's ready to weld in there to be a nice new piece. I've got a dent here to pull out, so I have to pull that this way to get it all square. But now we've got to go underneath and clean the underside of the car as well, so we get nice welds. Okay, so this is under the car. This is under the first piece we're going to weld in. We've got all the underseal and stuff that we need to clean off. And also, this exhaust pipe isn't in the ideal place. It's quite close, so cleaning that's going to be a little bit tricky. But I'm going to try and leave that in as much as I can, just because I can't be bothered to take it out. So we'll see what happens. But yeah, so it's time to clear up all this, get this all nicely welded in there, and start getting it all back to being nice and good. It's because that gap's a bit big. Right, on to the next one. Okay, starting to get this panel in now. You see it's got a rib on it as well. And we're just starting to tack it in, and I'll show you all that now. Okay, so that one's tacked in now as well. That one's tacked in, now I've got to do this one. Now there's one thing that you haven't been able to see me doing, which is using my trolley jack and a block of wood to make sure I'm pushing all the bits of metal together properly. So, and I'm holding it with magnets on top, but often it can fall a little bit at some corners and so on. So by using this and the trolley jack, I can push it all together, making sure it's all good and ready to weld. Time grinding it back and so on, and from the other side as well. Now it's time to get onto that hole there, and then start either this corner or that corner. This corner I've already made the patch for in here, but then you see I've got all this, so I might need to make another bit here, so maybe I'll start on this corner first. I was having quite a few problems with my welder with this one. I've only got a little Wolf Weld little toy thing, but very soon I have my 216 Portamig turning up. Hand-built machine. It's taken about four weeks by the time it gets here to replace that thing, just because it's a toy, it's unreliable. I'm battling it with the whole time. The wire feed, you know, it just can't keep up. It's overheating a lot of the time, so then the wire suddenly goes really slow and then you burn through. But anyway, I'll do a video on that sooner, how about that? But finally got that one done, a lot of patience, but we've got there.